Let's speak Korean.
J99회 오랜만에 고향 친구를 만났어.
안녕하세요. Hello everyone and welcome to Let's Speak Korean. I'm your host Lisa Kelly and today is our 99th episode. I like this number. And today's main expression is something that you might not hear back at home but here in Korea you hear quite often. 오랜만에 고향 친구를 만났어. After a long time, or I haven't seen someone for a long time, but I met my friend from my hometown or back home. We'll get into the explanation for this a little later. It's a little complicated. How are you, Stephen?
Good. How you doing, Lisa? 안녕하세요. I'm Stephen Revere. And the reason you'll hear this a lot more in Korea is a lot of people, especially in Seoul, have moved right. to Seoul from other cities, other places, kind of like us. Uh-huh. All of us have come here, so we all talk about our hometowns. But Koreans also, a lot of people have moved here from other towns. That's why every holiday there is incredible traffic, which I'm
Going
sure
back home,
you've
right.
seen.
Yeah. 안녕하세요, 네오미입니다.
안녕하세요, 삼입니다.
Right, and you guys are away from home, and I'm sure you miss your hometown. When's the next time you're going to go back to visit?
The summer holiday.
Oh, very soon. Yeah. What about you?
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Summer
Steve,
too.
You go back quite often too, once a year, twice a year?
I try to, but because of my graduate school, mm-hmm. I haven't been back in over a year and a half. So mm-hmm. I'm really looking forward to this summer myself because mm-hmm. it will have been a year and a half since right. I've seen my parents. That's too long.
I've been a bad daughter too. Mom, I'm going there soon. Okay, let's go. We've got a lot to cover today. Let's go to Let's Do It.
Let's Do It.
Lisa, 기분이 좋아 보인다.
오랜만에 고향 친구를 만났어.
Okay, the first expression we heard is Lisa, 기분이 좋아 보인다, and I do, right? You look like you're in a really good mood, and people say that a lot to express the mood, like 보인다, okay? It literally means to see or be seen, but they express it by saying, oh, you look good, or you look like you're in a good mood, or you look like you're in a bad mood, and they say 보인다, 뭐뭐 보인다, right?
Yeah, and 기분 in this case is mood, like you were saying, but normally it's feelings right. or emotions, so you've got to learn this expression, 기분이 좋다, right? Mm-hmm. 기분이 좋다 means I feel good, I'm happy,
good.
I'm in a good mood, right?
And Stephen, you look like 기분이 좋아 보인다. Mm-hmm. And here it's different because we've got like two verbs in this sentence, right? Mm-hmm.
Yes, 보이다 mm-hmm. is to look something, for something to be seen is actually
right.
what it is. So here, you look is 보이다, and then 좋아 보이다. You look good, you look happy, as we found out. Mm-hmm. So what you're going to be doing here, notice you always have to use an adjective when adding 어 보이다, 아 보이다 to something, right? So you could say 기분이 좋아 보이다 or 예뻐, of course, mm-hmm. is the common verb, the adjective that we always use. You look very pretty. 예뻐 보여, right? You look very pretty today. 어, 오늘 예뻐 보인다. And then 보인다, I'm sure you're familiar with this, that when you put that n-da on the end of a verb, you're showing a little bit of surprise. So Lisa walks in and I say, oh, hey, you look pretty happy today.
아, 기분이 좋아 보인다. Mm. Okay, why don't you guys make an observation using 보인다?
3위는 키가 커 보인다.
That's right, and he is
yeah.
too. Uh-huh.
Yeah. 우울해 보인다.
Oh, good one. 우울해 보인다 means you look sad, and I like that. Depressed. That's good.
Yeah, 우울하다, mm-hmm. right? To be depressed. 우울하다, and then 우울해 보인다. Ah, yes, very good. Why you look so depressed today? Mm.
Okay, well let's practice this one more time. 기분이 좋아 보인다, and then also try this. 기분이 좋다. That's when you're expressing yourself, not the observation. Mm.
기분이 좋아 보인다. 나는 기분이 좋다.
Good.
기분이 좋아 보인다. 아, 기분이 좋다.
Okay. All right. And I feel good. 기분 좋네요. Because you repeated it well. And our second expression, going into our main expression today, 오랜만에. After a long time, okay, there's been a passage of time. So sometimes in English we say long time no see. This is exactly when you would use that. 고향 친구를 만났다.
And Koreans do that all the time, mm-hmm. right? Too. Koreans have 오랜만에 mm-hmm. I've seen, it's a, been a long time, and Koreans have all learned the expression mm-hmm. "oh, long time no see."
Right.
You'll hear Koreans say that a lot too. Long time no
and
see.
And I like what Stephen just said. Okay, mm-hmm. remember, lots of people hear this word "오래간만에." Mm-hmm. Okay, it's the same as "오랜만에." It's actually shortened because it's used so often, as you just mentioned.
You're so good. Yeah. There's nothing for me to say. That's exactly right. They're the same thing. Mm-hmm. One little difference that you want to pay attention to is one is 오랜만에, right? Notice the N on the bottom of 된, okay? And the other one is 오래간만에. Yeah,
right.
A little difference.
And we have the substitute when you're doing the 인사, when you're saying hello to someone and you say, oh, long time no see, you can say 오래간만이에요. Okay, it's been a long time. This is how you say hello to someone if you haven't seen someone. So let's try that, okay? 오래간만이에요.
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 Right, and you hear this very often. People use this a lot. Okay, let's put this into a sentence, okay? Our example sentence was 오래간만에 고향 친구, oh, hometown, 고향 친구, hometown friend, or a friend from back home, okay? 고향 친구를 만났다. Try this once.
오래간만에 고향 친구를 만났다.
오래간만에 고향 친구를 만났다.
Or 만났어요. Tell me something that you haven't done or seen or eaten or something in a long time.
오래간만에 갈비를 먹었다.
Because it's so expensive.
오래간만에 매운 음식을 먹었다.
Okay, we've been teaching for since a long time. For a long time, I haven't done something. What if you want to say a long time by itself? 오랫동안.
Okay.
You can also use the expression 오랫동안 for a long, long time. 오랫동안. 책을 읽었다. I read a book for a long time.
Okay, tell me something you've done for a long time.
오랫동안 한국어를 배웠다.
Okay, very good. Yeah, okay. I've studied Korean for
a
long time.
Time. In
nice
case,
job.
In my case.
Yeah, me too. 오랫동안. 나도 오랫동안 배웠어. 배워봤어.
Right.
진짜.
And being a foreigner here in Korea, the first thing a foreigner will ask you, other than, you know, what your name is, probably 고향이 어디예요? They'll ask you, which country are you from? Or they can say 어디 나라에서 왔어요. But usually you'll hear 고향이 어디예요? So I'll ask you and you can answer for me. Naomi, 고향이 어디예요?
이태리 로마예요.
Oh, good. Ah. Tell me, 고향이 어디예요?
도키 볼루예요.
Oh, good.
What?
볼루.
볼루.
Yeah, 한국말로 볼루.
I see.
And another thing, when you want to say the negative, I haven't done something in a long time, or I haven't seen someone in a long time, you got to watch the pronunciation. I hear lots of mistakes, so let's try one, okay? 오랫동안 친구를 못 만났어요. Okay, be careful when you say 못 만났어요. Mm-hmm.
오랫동안 친구를 못 만났어요.
Mm-hmm. 오랫동안 친구를 못 만났어요.
And also a reminder, you can also say 안 something instead of 못. Stephen?
Yeah, notice on the 못 만났어요, mm-hmm. when you're pronouncing that 못, that shit, because mm-hmm. it comes before the 미음, right? Another consonant, it's not pronounced, it's just 못 만났어요. It's kind of like an N sound, isn't it, when it comes before an M. 못 만났어요.
Okay, very good. Let's go on to Wrap It Up.
Wrap It Up
with Lisa
and Steven.
Steven, 기분이 좋아 보인다.
응, 오랜만에 고향 친구를 만나러 가고 있어.
얼마 동안 고향 친구를 못 만났는데?
일주일 동안 못 만났어.
오케이, okay, we heard in the wrap it up 일주일 동안 blank blank blank. So we want to mention that you can specify how long. So you can say 한 달 동안 못 만났어요. Mm-hmm. 일주일 동안 못 만났어요.
Time period plus 동안, right? Mm-hmm. Time period plus 동안. Yeah.
Okay, quick review. Let's see how well you've mastered today's lesson. 아, 나오미 기분 좋아 보이는데요?
오랜만에 미용실 갔어요.
Oh, good. Okay, 쌤이 진짜 기분 좋아 보이네요.
오랜만에 도키 음식을 먹었어요.
고향
음식.
고향 음식. Okay. Well, I hope you look good today because you've joined us here at Let's Speak Korean. Please join us back here next time. Bye-bye.
And in the meantime, arirangtv.com. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.